Hello, and welcome to this RSNA case of the week, which is acute venous mesenteric ischemia. My name is Eli Rueda Chaparro, and I'm a 40-year diagnostic radiology resident at Pontificia Universidad Javeriana, Bogota, Colombia. This patient is a 75-year-old woman with a history of arterial hypertension presented to the emergency department with diffuse abdominal pain associated with emesis without mucus or blood. The patient was awake and responsive with elevated high blood pressure and tachycardia. Physical abdominal examination showed diffuse tenderness at palpation and percussion with predominance in the right lower quadrant and left lower quadrant. Positive lumbar and drafting signs were also shown. CVC showed elevated white blood count with elevated D-dimer and elevated lactate. Here it is, the axial acquisition of the non-enhanced phase of the abdominal CTA shows mild hyperattenuation of the superior mesenteric vein. Figure A is an axial acquisition of the portal phase of the abdominal CTA, shows portal vein enlargement with a hypodesk filling defect within the portal vein. Figure B is an axial image of the portal phase of the abdominal CTA, exhibits enlargement of the superior mesenteric vein. There is also a hypodesk filling defect within the vein. Note that the superior mesenteric artery is patent, as it is shown with a yellow arrow. Figure C is a coronal multiplanar reconstruction of the portal face of the abdominal CTA, shows the extension of the filling defect from the right intrahepatic portal vein through the main portal vein and through the entire length of the superior mesenteric vein, as it is shown with the blue arrow. Figure A is an axial acquisition of the portal face of the abdominal CTA, reveals concentric wall thickening of the bowel with no mural enhancement. There is also moderate mesenteric fat stranding with no opacification of the distal branches of the superior mesenteric vein. There is a coronal reconstruction of the portal face of the abdominal CTA, shows non-enhancement of the bowel wall, mesenteric fat stranding and intra-abdominal free fluid is also shown. Note that the enlargement of the superior mesenteric vein. The final diagnosis is acute venous mesenteric ischemia. CTA findings include concentric bowel wall thickening, bowel dilatation, and decreased wall enhancement, enlargement and hyperattenuation of the SMB in the non-enhanced phase of the abdominal CTA, and a filling defect within the mesenteric vein in the portal enhanced phase. Top differential diagnoses are acute arterial mesenteric ischemia and non-occlusive mesenteric ischemia, which the diagnostic findings are listed below. So the take-home messages are acute mesenteric ischemia has a high mortality around 44% due to its failure in early detection, delay in the medical management, and its relationship to bowel infarction and intestinal bacterial translocation, which leads to peritonitis. AMI has an arterial and venous etiology. Mesenteric venous thrombosis is the less common, with the superior mesenteric vein the vessel that is compromised in most of the cases. There are multiple potential clinical symptoms of AMI. However, patients will generally present with diffuse abdominal pain that gradually worsens, hyperlactic and leukocytosis due to the bowel inflammatory process. Abdominal CTA is the primary imaging with AMI is expected. CTA findings of venous mesenteric thrombosis include mural, vascular, and extramural signs. Mural signs are concentric bowel wall thickening and decreased wall enhancement due to the intramural edema. Vascular signs at the non-enhanced phase is enlargement of the SMB with an increase in its attenuation due to the presence of a thrombus. At the enhanced portal phase, we can see a complete or partial hyperattenuating filling defect within the mesenteric veins, which may or may not be accompanied with the vein enlargement. Extramural signs are pneumatosis intestinalis and portal mesenteric venous gas, mesenteric fat edema, also known as the misty mesentery, bowel dilatation, and free intraperitoneal air. I hope you enjoyed this presentation and thank you for watching.